Saturday Night Live is without a doubt one of the most fascinating forms of entertainment in America. Although with over 46 seasons now complete, it's safe to assume that there have been plenty of mishaps. Here are some of the biggest celebrities who have been banned from SNL for life. First up, Steven Seagal. Steven Seagal is an American actor, producer, writer, and director who's best known for his performances in Under Siege, Above the Law, and countless appearances on hit TV shows. Still, he will go down as one of the worst SNL hosts in history. In 1990, at the height of Seagal's fame, the action movie star was set to host the spring show of SNL, but refused to get along with the rest of the cast and crew. Reportedly, the famous action star insisted on working closely with the cast and crew and initiating his ideas into the majority of the sketches. Unfortunately, most of his ideas were terrible and immediately shot down by the rest of the SNL crew. The episode is widely regarded as one of the worst in SNL history, and there's even been numerous parody skits made on SNL of the infamous incident. Lorne Michaels called Steven Seagal's stint as guest host of the show the worst ever. Next, Louise Lasser. Louise Lasser was the wife of famous movie director Woody Allen, thus appearing in countless Hollywood films such as Take the Money and Run and Bananas. However, in 1976, she became the host of SNL in a performance that would end up becoming one of Lasser's greatest disappointments. At the time of her appearance as guest host of the show, the actress was going through some difficult times, with many describing her SNL performance as a hot mess. Reportedly, she was difficult and refused to appear in any sketches with actors other than Chevy Chase and appeared disoriented or almost incoherent at times. At one point, she even had a massive meltdown on stage and ran off into her dressing room. Lorne Michaels was so disappointed with the episode that he made sure NBC never aired reruns. Number 3. Frank Zappa. The major American musician and filmmaker was invited to be a musical guest on the show in 1976 and again as the host in 1978. Even though his musical performance during the first show went relatively well, his second appearance as the host of the show was not as successful. Fans of the iconic musician may not be too surprised to see Frank Zappa stir up controversy, but his stance on drugs and his relations with the rest of the SNL crew were not well received. The main reason for the big discord between the groups was Zappa's rigid anti-drug stance, which was the direct opposite point of view that the SNL cast had at the time. On top of that, Zappa would frequently stare directly into the camera, often mentioning to viewers that he was reading his lines from cue cards during the unscripted show. He was immediately banned from the show up until his untimely death in 1993. Also, Sinead O'Connor. The world-renowned Irish singer-songwriter was extremely popular through the late 80s and early 90s, and even appeared on SNL as a musical guest once before her incident in 1992. Her first performance on the show went smoothly, but in her second appearance, things started to get out of hand. O'Connor performed an a cappella version of Bob Marley's War, and without the cast or crew's knowledge, changed the lyrics up to fit her own political agenda. At the time, she was planning on protesting sexual abuse in the Roman Catholic Church and changed the lyrics to fit her cause, even doing so much as to hold up a photo of Pope John Paul II and tear it in half on camera, profoundly stating to fight the real enemy. This notorious stunt would go down in history as one of the most shocking events on the show, with many cast and crew members leaving the show in utter silence and confusion. Number 5. Martin Lawrence. Martin Lawrence, best known for his role in Bad Boys and Bad Boys 2, is an American actor and comedian who first got his start in the early 90s on his show, Martin. However, at the height of Lawrence's career, the famous actor and comedian was banned from appearing as a guest host on SNL. He was in the midst of his exceptionally successful TV show, Martin, when he appeared as the host of SNL in 1994 and made a mistake that would leave him permanently banned from the show. During his opening monologue, Lawrence started going off on a rant about feminine hygiene, making offensive comments regarding female genitalia. The monologue was edited out in reruns of the show, and many SNL cast members nearly lost their jobs in the aftermath of the event. Next up is Andy Kaufman. Andy Kaufman was a popular American actor and comedian best known for his role in Taxi, as well as his early performances on SNL. Due to his incredible appearances on the show, he was frequently invited back, even while many of his skits were dubbed controversial. The late Andy Kaufman was undoubtedly hilarious, but he was also notorious for going off script and taking things too far. And in 1983, Kaufman was a part of one of the strangest bands in SNL history. The executive producer at the time, Dick Ebersol, decided to leave the frequent guest stars fade up to the audience and put Kaufman's appearances on the show up to a vote, with the audience having the option to either ban him from the show or to keep him around. However, in a surprising turn of events, the audience voted to ban him. What's even more unfortunate is that just 1 year later, Kaufman passed away due to lung cancer and never returned to the SNL stage. Also, Chevy Chase. Believe it or not, but not only was Chevy Chase a part of the original cast of SNL in 1976, 1975, but he also became the first cast member to get permanently banned from hosting SNL. Chase was the very first host to perform the Weekend Update before seeing his epic role as Clark Griswold in the Vacation film series. While he did make several appearances on the show since his ban, explaining that his and Michael's relationship has since blossomed and the two remain friendly to this day, he hasn't hosted an episode since 97 when he reportedly slapped Sherry O'Terry in the back of the head, provoking fellow cast member Will Ferrell to report the incident to their higher-ups, despite Chase insisting it was a joke. However, this wasn't the only negative instance with Chase, as he also reportedly held intense feuds with Bill Murray, who replaced him, and Terry Sweeney, whom Chase verbally abused. Chevy Chase has long been associated with bad behavior on set, with numerous instances of the actor verbally abusing writers, actors, crew members, directors, and even producers. And his SNL fiasco in 1997 was just an example of the nonsense that Chase was known for. Number 8. Adrien Brody. Adrien Brody is unquestionably one of the most talented actors in the world, and was even the youngest actor to win an Oscar at just 29 years old in his role in The Pianist. Best known for his roles in The Pianist, King Kong, and The Grand Budapest Hotel, the Oscar-winning actor, director, and writer is one of Hollywood's biggest stars, and also one of the few that are permanently banned from SNL. Back in 2003, he was hosting an episode of SNL when things started going downhill. He gave an improvised introduction, which Lorne Michaels is typically not a fan of, where he wore faux dreadlocks in honor of the reggae musical guest Sean Paul. Michaels was so upset with Brody's performance that he permanently banned him from appearing on the show. Next up is Milton Berle. Many may find it hard to believe that the once beloved Uncle Milty, or Mr. Television, was actually banned from hosting SNL permanently back in the late 70s. Berle was a popular child and vaudeville actor, radio personality, and television actor who co-hosted NBC's Texas Star Theater beginning in 1948. With Berle's show off to the races, NBC wanted him to appear as guest host on an episode of SNL, and in 1979, their request was granted. However, apparently the cast members of SNL were not exactly thrilled to be working with the TV legend, especially once Milton began micromanaging everyone on set. He had somewhat of a reputation for taking over the production of TV shows, and according to the SNL writers, his outlandish behavior and inability to let the show creators do their thing are what led Berle to get banished permanently from the show. Not to mention the fact that Milton had a tendency to walk around in his underwear and expose himself to just about anybody on set. Lorne Michaels even barred the episode from being rerun because of fear that it might damage the show's reputation. And finally, Cypress Hill. The hit music group were at the height of their popularity in 1993 when they were asked to come on as the musical guest of an episode of SNL. The band was well known for being a little reckless and not holding back on their controversial antics, and this became even more evident during their 93 SNL appearance. During the live performance, DJ Muggs blatantly lit up a joint on stage and smoked it throughout the entire musical performance of their first set. During the band's second set, I Ain't Going Out Like That, the band then proceeded to trash the SNL stage, destroying all of the instruments on stage in the process. This was more than enough to justify the band receiving a lifetime ban from the show. And with that, it wraps up the video. Thanks for watching.